We've heard a lot about extreme events in recent years.
Across the globe, cataclysmic weather events are occurring with such regularity that it's being called a new normal. But there's nothing normal about it. Dirty energy has created a world of dirty weather.
So what's the evidence? Is extreme weather becoming the new normal? According to some climate predictions, as our planet warms due to accumulating greenhouse gases, the number and intensity of extreme weather events will increase. Some believe it's already happening, and that the heat waves and storms we've seen recently are occurring more often.
I think what we're seeing happening just in these last few years seems to be very consistent with what the models are projecting for the end of the century.
According to some scientists, like Professor Jennifer Francis of Rutgers University, it's already happening. But there are other views. Dr. Roger Pilkey Jr. of the University of Colorado says there hasn't been a recent change in extreme weather events.
There are no upwards trends in the number of tropical cyclones, of which hurricanes are a subset. Drought in the United States or globally. Floods, again, in the United States or globally. Or tornadoes. The science of extreme events and trends is among the least complicated you'll find in climate science, because phenomena like hurricanes are big. You don't miss them when they occur. And they're rare events, so there's not a lot to count. It's going to be many decades, maybe centuries, before we actually can detect, according to the IPCC definition of detection, a change in the statistics of these events.
Well, you're right. There are different views on that. The problem is that before we had satellite information, it was difficult to know for sure whether we had records of all the hurricanes that actually occurred, because unless it hit a ship or, you know, there was somebody there to measure it before a satellite could see it, then it might have gone undetected.
So what's going on? Are strong hurricanes on the increase? In 2012, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change issued its report on extreme weather events and concluded that apart from warmer days and increased extreme precipitation, there's no evidence of hurricanes, storms, tornadoes, and floods occurring more frequently. But it seems that many are accepting speculation as fact, assuming that extreme events are more common and linked to global warming, despite what the science says.
A way forward on this debate was to focus on the things that have meaning to people in their immediate context. And extreme weather, which would seem to have a relationship to broader climate change, is the hook that's been chosen.
Heat waves, droughts, wildfires, floods, all are now more frequent and more intense. We can choose to believe that Superstorm Sandy and the most severe drought in decades and the worst wildfires some states have ever seen were all just a freak coincidence. Or we can choose to believe in the overwhelming judgment of science and act before it's too late.
On that instance, President Obama was simply incorrect. Politicians say all sorts of things. More troubling than President Obama kind of getting forward on his skis is the absolute and complete silence among my colleagues in the scientific community. It seems that there's a double standard here, that if President Obama says something that's incorrect, he gets a free pass. But if, say, Senator James Inhofe says something that's incorrect, he gets roundly criticized.
People are noticing that the weather patterns are changing. They're hearing scientists say more and more that there are these connections between climate change and these extreme weather events that they're experiencing. They can see with their very own eyes that the Arctic sea ice has diminished by approximately half. People are really starting to pay attention. The media are paying attention. Even politicians are paying attention. So I think we're maybe going to see some action now.
With the global temperature of the Earth's land and ocean surface showing no rise in over 16 years, it seems that some are turning to extreme weather events as a more obvious manifestation of global warming. The problem is that despite many treating it as a well-established fact, there is presently no definite evidence for it.
There was once a land where the weather was very, very strange. There were awful heat waves in some parts, and in others, terrible storms and floods.
We're in danger of letting the politics of extreme weather events lead the science, and letting policies reflect impressions and not evidence.